We wanted to make a political point about an organization that's pulling off some of the world's biggest hoaxes. No, not this organization. The one across the street. The one that looks like a US government office, but really is working against the government. In reality, the US Chamber of Commerce is a large corporation that is reported to lie to the public on behalf of even bigger corporations. They spend nearly $500,000 a day trying to convince the US government to do really stupid shit, like killing environmental regulations and undermining workers' rights. But since they spend so much money on their hoaxes, many people believe them.
And as it says, American free enterprise dream big, but their dreams are our nightmares because their plans are to prevent us from passing climate change legislation, which means we're screwed.
Since the chamber was hoaxing us all, we decided to fight fire with fire. We would reveal one of their biggest lies by masquerading as them. We would hold a press conference as the chamber at the National Press Club. How would the world react to the chamber suddenly reversing its position on climate change?
But a reversal on climate change from the U.S. Chamber of Commerce. It will reverse its position on the climate change bill and wants a carbon tax, if you will. All right, so the U.S. Chamber is denying it now. All right, so maybe not. Apparently it was a hoax. Either there is a group or some people or a person.
Is there any involvement of the White House whatsoever?
I couldn't even begin to go there, Larry. This is the item we got. It has the chamber's logo that we're all very familiar with.
Today, the country's largest business lobby, the Chamber of Commerce, got punked. It began early this morning when a press release went out, purportedly from the United States Chamber of Commerce. Amazingly, the release said that the chamber would now support this legislation that it's spent months fighting against. Reporters were surprised and probably confused at this odd turn of events, but that was nothing compared to what actually happened at the press conference when it was held later on this morning. Watch this tape.
Clean coal is a technology that has not only not been proven, it basically doesn't exist.
Okay, this is, I'm Eric Wolfschlegel. I'm with the U.S. Chamber of Commerce. This is not an official U.S. Chamber of Commerce event. So I don't know what pretenses you're here. I know some of you in the press world, but this is a fraudulent press activity and a stunt.
Who are you really, sir?
And do you have a business card? Are you with the U.S. Chamber?
I do. We can discuss afterwards.
Okay. Can I see your business card?
Can I see yours?
Are you here representing the U.S. Chamber of Commerce?
Yes, I am.
Okay, well, I work there, and you do not look familiar to me at all.
Could I see your business card?
Is this a stunt?
Could I see your business
card? Is this a
stunt? Are you interrupting a president?
Yes, I am. And this guy does not represent the U.S. Chamber of Commerce.
Can we finish
the interview? Okay? No. This is not an official Chamber of Commerce. This is not... What is your position at the Chamber of Commerce?
I just spoke my position.
We've got working.
What is your title and your official title at the U.S. Chamber of Commerce?
I'm the assistant to Mr. Donahue.
Okay. This guy is a fraud. He's lying. This is, you know, a stunt that I've never seen before. So if you'd like to actually talk to the legitimate Chamber of Commerce, I've got my business cards outside. This gentleman, I will assure you, does not have any business cards, and he's not legitimate.
Show me your business card. No, show me yours. No, show me yours.
Yeah, they both look like imposters. What?
It's just, you got a business card?
It's so weird, though. But
you don't look familiar.
The U.S. Chamber of Commerce says it was victimized.
Victims of a hoax by environmental activists.
A hoax actually led to the chamber admitting that there is a challenge for climate change. It seems like a good first step. So next up, hoaxes about poverty, violence,
education.
Hunger.
The big education hoax. We've got a big education hoax in this
country. The hoax is a good first step.
Yeah.
Just today, the Chamber of Commerce changed positions, not courtesy of the yes men with that stunt in Washington a few weeks ago. But they're now saying, surprisingly to me, and I'm glad about it, that they want to get legislation, and they're now working with the sponsors of the bill.